In the mode of acquisition, but this time using issuance of equity securities in acquiring your long-term assets or property, plant, and equipment. So our learning objective is the same with the or from the previous module. So that is for you to account for initial recognition of property, plant, and equipment, this time by issuing equity securities. So from the previous module, so what we have studied is that the mode of acquisition by deferred payment plans, but this time by issuing equity securities. And so key notes. So first, the purchase price assigned to the asset received is its fair market value. So kapag given yung cash price equivalent, so ang assumption natin, yung cash price equivalent will be the same with the fair market value. So ito yung cash price. Ayan. Cash price equivalent. Therefore, so kapag given yung cash price equivalent o fair market value ng assets, ang assumption natin, that is the reliable estimates or measure of the value of the asset. So i-record natin yung asset at fair market value or at its cash price. Ayan, sabi niya, asset should be recorded as its fair market value or the cash price equivalent. Ngayon, in case yung cash price equivalents are not provided in the problem, that's the time lang na magre-refer tayo dun sa fair market value ng shares of stocks. So sabi niya, in rare cases when the fair market value of the assets received cannot be estimated reliably, the cost is determined by reference to the fair value of the equity instruments granted. So, kung hindi given or determinable yung fair market value ng assets or walang cash price equivalent, so that's the time magre-refer tayo dun sa fair market value ng shares of stocks. So, to further illustrate, let's solve a problem. Example problem. So, sabi niya, on February 1, 2019, ABC Corporation issued 5,000 of its ordinary shares in exchange for 5 acres of land. So, land yung binili. So, hindi naman nagde-depreciate yung land. So, ito yung mga requirements and assumption. So, una, if the cash price of the 5 acres land is equal to 1 million, so given yung cash price, so yan din yung fair market value ng land. And the par value of the shares issued is 180 per share with market value of 190 per share. So, how much should be debited for the land? The letter B, if the cash price of the 5 acres of land is equal to 1 million and the ordinary shares issued has no par value. So, this time, walang par. So, wala namang bigay stated value. So, no par, no stated value again. But with market value of 190 per share, so how much should be debited for land? So letter C, if there is no available cash price for the land, how much should be debited to land in letter A and B? So this time, dito kasi sa A and B, meron tayong cash price equivalent for the asset. Pero sa letter C, assuming, paano kung wala? So that's the time na magre-refer tayo dun sa shares of stocks. I mean dun sa letter C, shares of stocks tayo. Pagkatan na natin. So for letter A, if the cash price of the 5 acres of land is equals to 1 million, so take note, this is the cash price. So, ang assumption natin, yung cash price, yan yung fair market value. So, 1 million daw yan. And the par value of the shares issued is 180 per share. Ang market value is 190. So, since given yung fair market value ng land o yung cash price equivalent ng land, hindi na relevant yung 190 per share. So, ang tanong, how much should be debited for land? So, ang magiging entry mo dyan ng February 1. So, this, ayos mo ulit. 2120. So, magde-debit ako ng land. Siyempre, given yung cash price equivalent, dun tayo sa cash price. So, ang sagot natin talaga dito sa letter A is 1 million. Kasi yan yung fair market value ng land. So, ang journal entry mo is debit to land. 1 million, credit tayo ng ordinary share capital kasi nag-issue tayo ng shares. Ordinary share capital, ang assumption is ordinary shares yung in-issue. This is for the par value. So, 180 times 5,000. 180 per share times 5,000 shares. So, magkano yan? So, 180 times 5,000. So, that will give us 900,000. Pero ang debit natin is 1 million kasi meron tayong share premium. Ayan. So, share premium for the ordinary shares for 100,000. So, from this journal entry, so, in-ignore ko yung 190 na fair market value ng shares kasi nga, order of priority, kapag given yung cash price o fair market value ng assets, yun yung i-recognize. And, ang ordinary share capital always credited for the par value. So, yung difference yung debit mo tsaka credit mo, that will be credited to share premium. Premium is additional lang. So, requirement B. So, sa letter B, this time naman, the cash price is still 1 million, but this time, no par value. So, wala tayong par value. So, actually, mas madali ito. Since given naman yung cash price, so, yan yung fair market value. So, ang rule, pag given yung cash price or fair market value, yung asset should be debited at cash price or fair, or its fair market value. So, ang entry natin ng February 1, 2020, or 19 yata yun, is debit to land. Kasi land yung biniling asset. This is for 1 million. Then, credit tayo ng ordinary share capital. Medyo naghang. Ordinary share capital. Since no par, edi yung buong 1 million. Hindi natin ulit papansinin yung 190,000. Kasi given naman yung market value ng land. So, ganyan lang. So, wala tayong premium. Ba't walang premium? Eh, kasi wala namang par value na binigay. No par nga kasi siya. No par, no stated value. Kung given yung stated value, so, ang ordinary share capital mo will be credited at stated value. So, yung difference ulit ng debit mo tsaka credit mo, share premium ulit siya. So, parang par value lang din. Ang pinagkaiba lang nila, pag meron tayong par value, ibig sabihin yung par value is indicated dun sa stock certificate o share certificate. Pero yung stated value, wala dun sa stock certificate, pero nandun siya sa articles of incorporation. So, yun lang ang pinagkaiba nila. Letter C. So, how about kung this time wala tayong cash price equivalent? If that is the case, magre-refer tayo dun sa fair market value of the share. So, remember, dun sa letter A, ang par value ng shares is 180 per share, pero ang fair market value nung shares is 190. So, since wala tayong cash price equivalent, refer tayo dun sa fair market value ng shares, which is 190. So, ang magiging entry natin ng February 1 will be debit to land. So, this is 190 per share. I-multiply ko lang ng 5,000 kasi 5,000 shares yung in-issue na ordinary shares. So, 190 times 5,000. So, that is 950,000. So, credit ako ng ordinary share capital. O, take note, this is naka-par value pa rin kasi given yung par value, which is 180. So, this is 180 multiplied by 5,000 shares. So, this is 900,000. So, yung difference nila will be share premium. So, which is 50,000. Ayan. So, sa letter B naman, ang par value is 0. Kasi no par value yun, di ba? No par value, pero ang market, ang fair market value ng shares mo is also 190. Edi, mas madali ito. Kasi ang magiging entry mo lang, debit tayo sa land, edi equal ulit dun sa 150,000. So, paano na compute 950? Parang ito na sa letter A. 190 times 5,000. So, 950 yun. Pero, wala tayong premium kasi no par na siya. So, ang credit ko lang is ordinary share capital. This is for 950,000. Yan. Ganyan lang kadali. So, that's the end of module 2.3. So, ang 2.2. So, ang next module natin is 2.3. Pag-usapan naman natin, how about if the mode of acquisition will be by donation. So it's either donated by existing shareholders, donated by an individual without any connection to the firm, or by the government. Ito tawag natin na government grants. In case you have question, please let me know by sending me a message through Blackboard or Messenger. Thank you.